From those who used to finish three times every day, Sulaym ibn Utr radiallahu anhu, the judge of Misr in the Khilaf of Muawiyah, فروى أبو بكر بن أبي داود أنه كان يختم في كل ليلة ثلاث ختمات. Ibn Abi Dawood says that he used to finish, meaning Sulaym ibn Utr, he used to finish three times every night. وروى أبو عمر الكندي في كتابه في قضاة مصر أنه كان يختم في الليل أربع ختمات. Another source says he finished four times every night. وقال الشيخ الصالح الإمام أبو عبد الرحمن السلمي رضي الله عنه سمعت الشيخ أبي عثمان المغربي يقول كان ابن الكاتب رضي الله عنه يختم بالنهار أربع ختمات وبالليل أربع ختمات وهذا أكثر ما بلغنا في اليوم والليل. The person who has, you can say, the record for that which has reached us, because Allah knows best of his actions of his servants. To the one who did the most was Ibn al-Katib, and his full name is Hassan ibn Ahmed Abu Ali ibn al-Katib. من كبار مشايخ المصريين وكان أبو عثمان المغربي يعظمه. He passed away in the year 340. This is in Tabaqat al-Sufiyya for Sulami. So Ibn al-Katib used to finish eight times a day, four khatam in the day, four khatam in the night. And Ahmad al-Dawraqi narrates from Mansur ibn Zadan that some of the worshippers of the Tabi'een, they used to finish the Quran between Dhuhr and Asr. Some of them would finish between Maghrib and Isha. And they would finish it between Maghrib and Isha and Ramadan twice. And they used to delay the Isha and Ramadan until one-fourth of the night had passed. Ibn Abi Dawood narrates with an authentic change that Mujahid, the Sunan of Ibn Abbas, used to finish the Quran in Ramadan between Maghrib and Isha in every night of Ramadan. Mansur, and his full name is Ibn al-Mu'tamar al-Sulami Abu Hattab al-Kufi. And they said he was the most of memorizing in the people of Kufa in his time, and he was consistent in fasting and praying at night, and he died in the year 132 in Hijra, after the Hijra, and this is mentioned in Sir al-A'lam by Dhahabi. So Mansur, he says, Ali al-Azdi used to finish the Quran between Maghrib and Isha every night in Ramadan. Ibrahim ibn Sa'ad says that Abi Yahtabi فما يحل حبته حتى يختم القرآن. الله أكبر. The footnotes explain that قوله يعتبي أي ينصب ساقيه ويحتوي على ملتقى ساقيه وفخذيه بيديه أو بثوب والحبوة. Okay. So that this that Abi Yahtabi, that he would not turn his shins, like meaning he would sit in the same position and not put his, or he would put his hands over his thighs and in a seated position with his shins until he completed the Qur'an. He would not move from that position. As for those who finish the Qur'an in a single rak'ah, that there's many of them, but they include Uthman ibn Affan, Tamim al-Dari, Sa'id ibn Jubair. They finish the Qur'an in one rak'ah in front of the Kaaba. You know, some people can stand at a concert all night. They can wait in line on Black Friday for hours, and they don't feel any fatigue really, because they're enjoying the experience. Some people can do so much for the disobedience of Allah, but the book of Allah, some people have an intense addiction to it, that they don't feel fatigue, swelling, pain, because they're in ecstasy reading the book of Allah subhanahu وتعالى. As for those who finish the Quran once a week, there are many. As mentioned, Uthman ibn Affan, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Zayd ibn Thabit, Ubay ibn Ka'b, may Allah be pleased with them. And for those of the next generation of the Tabi'un, Abdurrahman ibn Yazid, Alqama, Ibrahim al-Nakhi, Rahimahumullah. And then Ibn Nawawi gives his own advice, and he says that this should be wal-ikhtiyar, that the person should select according to the capability of the person. As for the one who is capable of having precision in his thought and reflecting on the nuances and the subtleties of the Quran, then he should shorten his regimen of recitation so that he can have complete understanding of what he's reading. وَكَذَا مَنْ كَانَ مَشْغُولًا بِنَشْرِ الْعِلْمِ. As for the one who's busy in teaching Islamic sciences or other important matters of the religion and the affairs of the general Muslims, they should decrease their portion. لا يحصل بسببه إخلال بما هو مرصد له. He should shorten his portion of recitation to an amount that, because of it, he will not be negligent of that which he is watchful over or responsible of. وإن لم يكن من هؤلاء المذكورين فليستكثر ما أمكنه. But if he's not from what has been mentioned of these categories, he should increase as much as he can. من غير خروج إلى حد الملل والهذرمة. Without exceeding the limits to the point that they get bored or reading too fast. And some of the earlier scholars, they disliked the fact that the Quran be recited in just one day and one night. And the evidence for this is the authentic hadith from Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiyallahu anhuma, that the Prophet, Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, لا يفقه من قرأ القرآن في أقل من ثلاث. رواه أبو داود والترمذي والنسائي وغيرهم. وقال الترمذي حديث حسن صحيح. الله أعلم. That the person who recites the Quran, he does not understand it, or the person who recites the Quran in less than 3 days has not fully understood it. Which teaches us the point is not just to read and read and read and read, although there is a great blessing in reading the Book of Allah, but a part of it is to contemplate on what is being recited and to understand the meaning, and that way act upon it. وأما وقت الابتداء والختم لمن يختم في الأسبوع. What is the time someone should start their recitation and end if they finish every week? فقد روى ابن أبي داود بإسناده أن عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنه كان يفتتح القرآن ليلة الجمعة ويختمه ليلة الخميس. That Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu, he used to start his recitation the night of Friday night, the night of Jum'ah, which in the West would be Thursday night, because Islamically days start at Maghrib and they end at sunset. So he would start in the night of Friday, so the Maghrib of Thursday, and then he would finish the Thursday night, so after sunset Thursday he starts his recitation, and then by the next Thursday Asr he's done. وقال الإمام أبو حامد الغزالي رحمه الله في الإحياء الأفضل أن يختم ختمة بالليل وأخرى بالنهار ويجعل ختمة النهار يوم الاثنين في صلاة في ركعتي الفجر أو بعدهما, ويجعل ختمة الليل ليلة الجمعة في ركعتي المغرب أو بعدهما ليستقبل أول النهار وآخره. And now we quote Abu Hamid al-Ghazali, may Allah have mercy on him, that The best is for him to complete the Quran once at night and then the other at day. So the one at night he finishes on, he finishes Fajr on Monday, and another one he finishes on Friday night. So then at Maghrib, he finishes Friday night at Maghrib, and he makes the next finish on Monday Fajr. So then that way he gets the balance of finishing the Quran in both in the day and the night. And another tradition regarding this, narrated by Ibn Abi Dawud from Amr ibn Murrah rahimahullah, that كانوا يحبون أن يختم القرآن من أول الليل أو من أول النهار. That the early generations, Amr ibn Murrah passed in the year 116 after the Hijrah, so he was very early, they used to love finishing the Quran in the beginning of the day or beginning of the night. وعن طلحة بن مصرف التابعي الجليل قال من ختم القرآن أية ساعة كانت من النهار صلت عليه الملائكة حتى يمسي وأية ساعة كانت من الليل صلت عليه الملائكة حتى يصبح وعن مجاهد نحوه. So this is not a hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, but just a teaching of the earlier generations, that whoever finishes the Quran in the hours of the day, then the angels will pray for his forgiveness until the night, and whoever finishes at night, they will pray for him until the day. So this is from Talha ibn Musarrif, who passed in the year 112 after the Hijrah. And he says Mujahid also, Mujahid ibn Jabr, the student of Ibn Abbas, had a similar statement. And Imam al-Darimi rahimahullah, he mentioned his musnad with a chain to Sa'ad ibn Abi Waqqas, the famous companion of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, قال إذا وافق ختم القرآن أول الليل صلت عليه الملائكة حتى يصبح وإن وافق ختمه آخر الليل صلت عليه الملائكة حتى يمسي. قال الدارمي هذا حسن عن سعد. So this is the same situation, but it has more weight in this statement because it is from a companion of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, who was from the Ashr al-Mubashara, the 10 best companions, the early سابقون الأولون من المهاجرين سعد ابن أبي وقاص رضي الله عنه. So he said the same, that if a person's completion of the Quran, it coincides with the beginning of the night, the angels will pray for that person until the morning, and if it coincides in the beginning of the day, they will pray for him the rest of the day. So this is just an encouragement for us that wherever we may be, we have this goal and we have this desire to be around the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that whatever we may be doing, you know, some people have this custom of reciting the Quran in the midst of their daily activities, that their tongue is accustomed to reading the Book of Allah. But of course, if one can give their full undivided attention to the Book of Allah and recite it, and even looking in the Mus'haf, this is more meritorious. But without that, ما لا يدرك كله لا يترك جله. Whatever cannot be done completely should not be left partially. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us. Inshallah, we'll continue for the rest of the months before Ramadan. Rajab is close, Sha'ban, Ramadan, and always trying to engage with the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and increase our devotion to it. Hadha wallahu ta'ala a'lam wa sallallahu ta'ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillah rabbil alamin.